A good author, whose heart is really in his subject, wishes that someone would come and annihilate him by presenting the same subject with greater clarity and resolving all the questions contained in it. A girl in love wishes the faithfulness and devotion of her love could be tested by the faithlessness of the man she loves. A soldier wishes he could fall on the battlefield for his victorious fatherland, for his supreme desire is victor in the victory of his fatherland. A mother gives to her child that of which she deprives herself, sleep, the best food, if need be her health, her strength. But are these all unegoistic states? Are these deeds of morality miracles because they are, in Schopenhauer's words, impossible and yet real? Is it not clear that in all these instances, man loves something of himself, an idea, a desire, an offspring, more than something else of himself? That he thus divides his nature and sacrifices one part of it to the other? Is it something essentially different from when some obstinate man says, "I would rather be shot down than move an inch out of that fellow's way"? The inclination for something, wish, impulse, desire, is present in all the above-mentioned instances. To give in to it, with all the consequences, is in any event not unegoistic. In morality, man treats himself not as individuum, but as dividuum.